really bright. My camera battery died on me, so I'm using my GoPro. We are now leaving Our Lady of Victory Basilica. A beautiful church, amazing, amazing church. Praise God for people like Father Baker, who understood the value of beauty and the need for it here in the United States, even in the early 20th century. I don't know if you can hear my daughter, but I'll talk more about this beautiful basilica in a little while.
All right, so I have a couple of minutes. My daughter is taking a shower right now. Not sure how long she's gonna stay in there, so just here we go. I'm going to leave some links down below of the Basilica website, sorry, my daughter, as well as a video that I found that gives some really great details and information, more than what I'm gonna give you here, but I just wanna give you three quick things. Number one is you're never too old to dream big dreams. Why do I say that? It's because Father Baker was in his 70s when he came to the parish council, if you will. Basically, the people were talking, well, actually, let me back up. The original church was St. Patrick's, and St. Patrick's had a fire in the early 1910s, if I remember right. And so they were looking to rebuild, restructure how they're going to pay for it and what they're going to rebuild it into. When Father Baker came in one night, just nonchalantly threw down the plans for that basilica and said, this is what I want to build, and it's going to cost $5 million. Mind you, this is $5 million in the 1920s. There are churches today being built for less than that here in the United States, let alone back in the 1920s. As you can imagine, that's a lot of money, even back then, especially back then. That's what I meant to say. So he was able to pay for it. He got donors, mostly just nickel, dime, dollars, whenever he could just pull together, but he got it paid, completely paid for, even before a single brick was laid. Just tons of marble. He chose the finest marble and the finest wood, the finest stone from all over the world. He chose the best architects, he chose the best sculptors, the best painters, anyone and everyone he could pull from, whether it was here in the United States or across in Europe. The second is that statue of Our Lady of Victory in the main sanctuary that you saw. That was personally hand-blessed by Pope Pius XI, which is just phenomenal. That's just gives me goosebumps thinking about that, that a Holy Father had blessed that statue personally is incredible. And number three is the sheer size and the beauty of it. So the dome, as y'all saw, in the 1920s, the only dome that was larger than that one was in the U.S. Capitol. It was also the second registered or officially recognized as a basilica. I don't know what the first one is. I'm going to have to look that up because I'm dying to know, because I want to go there now on pilgrimage. But it's not bad, not too shabby for the second recognized basilica in the United States. So yeah, that will do it for this video. Again, I just want to really stress why the church desperately needs beauty now more than ever. And that church was just magnificent. If you're in the New York area, if you're in Ohio, Pennsylvania, anywhere along the East Coast, I would highly, highly recommend going on pilgrimage to Our Lady of Victory Basilica Shrine. It's just absolutely gorgeous. Also, if you're in the New York area, I would also recommend going to the North American Martyrs Shrine, which actually, fun fact, I'll be going there in a few days. So stay tuned for that video coming up very soon. And yeah, I'll see you on the next one. Remember to like, subscribe, all that good stuff. All right, I'll talk to you later.